So, first of all, welcome to this BOF. We originally had it scheduled as talk. We now converted a bit more to a BOF because there are a lot of things we should discuss about within the stable release team. And also with people who are connected, who are working quite much for it, even if they are not an official member of the team. So first introductions. My name is Andi Barth. I'm one of the two stable release managers. Also the stable release team are Dan, Luke, who's also of some interest here, is of course Franz for the installer, AJ is FTP master, Steve is former unstable release manager.
Release wizard.
I'm this guy.
I'm not saying the other titles that's on the slides. So lots of other people we know, Sam, Wouter. So okay, there's a few people that don't know the name, so I can use themselves.
Okay, we are. This is first like a Debian conference for us. Okay. And okay, we are like a working in Nokia, okay, and doing this Mimo stuff. And okay, I was thinking that I'm not totally sure if this is right place to be, but I was thinking that if there is something related to release management and so on, so
yes.
The first question is that basically what you are going to like discuss and
basically my plan for now was that I just say a few words how do stable points of this work at all, because not everybody knows it, and then we can just discuss topics that come up from that that people already have brought with them. I hope that sounds like a good plan.
This first part, that how it works and so on, so to get the understanding,
did you say what your names were?
Janne Manninen.
One of those. One of those, you can also pronounce it in reverse, so you can at least.
So we should be making up nicknames now.
That will work.
Janne Manninen?
Yeah.
Okay.
And he's a he speaks almost every language, so he's a
I can read the letters.
Okay, anyway, so now...
Basically, interest observer.
Yeah.
That's okay, of course. That's one of the reasons why we do such things.
Thank you.
Okay?
Yeah. We are... So... I'm with Yanni, and I'm also working for Nokia, same for the member things, and just generally I'm the same cover as Yanni to be here, so
okay.
Yeah, just feel free to talk.
So, you're welcome. So,
I'm Frankie, I was on board a bit with Volatile, if you remember.
Yes.
The web part of the blog done. Basically, I'm interested in listening to you. What's this changing that stable release management?
So
if something is changing.
Okay. So then I will perhaps just tell how currently stable releases work. What we have, or what you all know, is basically we have all the packages in one suite in FTP master called stable. Where the packages stay. Then if somebody has a change to upload, he should, of course, first speak with the stable release team that the changes looks okay for us. And then if the change is uploaded, it goes to a separate directory on FTP master, where we could review the package and say yes, it's okay, or no, it's not okay, or just leave it there and send a mail and say, please, another try would be nice. And if you accept the package, it's now automatically installed in the so-called suite proposed updates. And on the points release, if we release a points release, the packages from the proposed updates are then installed in the stable suite, used these are generated. So it doesn't look too complicated. Like, there are a lot of things involved. For example, if we update the new kernel, things probably need to change for the installer. Then a new installer needs to be uploaded, which was just done. Then the CD images needs to be rebuilt. So, and that was on the technical side of how stable updates work. There's a non-technical side, so what do we want to have in a stable update? What do we accept as packages? For us, it's very important to say, well, things shouldn't break for the users of Debian. I think that's our uttermost goal, to say it needs to continue working. And so, for sometimes there are changes which are very important. For example, if we have a security change, we might need to accept things that are not so nice. I can remember well the sudo update. That was a bad example.
Yeah. Or Samba. That's a more recent example.
But that was a mistake.
Security. That was a bug at least. I mean,
that was a mistake. Well, of course, mistakes happen. That's one thing. But the other is with sudo, we really said, well, we are going to break configurations, yeah, but we decided it to be more safe to break stuff, which doesn't make me happy. But I wasn't in the role to make any decision on that at that time anyways. So I can just say it sometimes happens, but usually it doesn't. What we are going now as well is to say, well, sometimes there are really very disturbing bugs where fixing them isn't risky at all, but would help our users. For example, if we add new PCI IDs to an existing piece of hardware in the kernel, that might help users, but it's not really risky. So we can still do it. So basically, the higher the risk is, the more relevance the bug needs to have. So if it's a very, very, very bad security bug, we are going to accept more risks than for just making the life of a few people a bit easier. I think that's a fair approach. Mm-hmm. And other than that, if there are different opinions what's okay or what not, we have to let in the release mailing list, where I, of course, often say it's not a discussion list, but it doesn't mean that it needs to be a total quiet. We use that list to sometimes get a common opinion. Of course, nobody, even if they are part of the release team, is always right. We do make mistakes also as release managers, but we try to learn from them and do it better. So that was now for a short introduction, and I think at least one or two people now have something in mind to speak like Franz.
I have two things. The first is a little note. You said if we do kernel RP updates, we have to update the installer. That is no longer strictly true, because the separation between the installer and the installed system is much better than it was for Sarge.
You mean
because we only use kernel meta packages now for installation. So basically, it does not matter what we are running in the installer for the installed system.
Now means Edge.
Actually, yes.
When you install a system right now, it still installs the old kernel, and then you need to upgrade and you get a new one. That's what I saw.
No.
That's what I've been seeing the last few days.
It will take whatever kernel is referenced by the current meta packages. So if you're currently installing testing, yes, you will get 2.6.18 because that is the testing kernel.
Actually, Wouter, I think there's one case where you will still get the older kernel. That is if you install from a full CD build without net access, and then upgrade with the net. Because then the newest kernel is the old kernel.
No, I've been installing 10 systems over the last few weeks with net install, and I get a situation where I need to upgrade the kernel after booting.
Perhaps we should
Net install includes the kernels on the disk as well.
Yes.
So you will get those kernels installed before the security app source is at.
Yeah. Oh, that could be
upgrade, right? But if you rebuild the disks, that's not an issue anymore.
Yes, that's correct. So with point release, you will get the new kernels on the disk anyway. So the next question is, do you want to update the installer as well? And I think it's a good rule to do it if you have ABI changing updates, but there isn't the strict necessity anymore that we had for Sarge.
Okay.
Because the ABIs were hard coded in some of the DI components.
Only on some architectures.
Right? On some architectures, yeah.
But you said the case that where it was the kicker where it was so. Yeah.
So that's just a little update on what we have to do and what we second thing is, and that's my most important request for stable release management, is I would like to have all the information that's available accessible more easily from the release Debian org page.
Yes.
Please update that. Make sections for all stable and old stable, and add links to.
Okay, I can just say something. We are planning to do that. There's one thing what we would like to see, and why I wanted to speak with this via DebConf about. We would like to move the release Debian org web page to the same machine where FTP master is running, because it would make our life way easier.
Mm-hmm.
But when I last spoke with some DSA about it, he said, well, we need to check that with FTP master first. So, last time it was still running on Spore, but it was obviously a non-option to do it.
At least on Spore, not on Block.
It wasn't.
Oh, sorry, when FTP master
was on Spore.
Right.
So, yeah. But now it moved, so we could do that, and then we could change it.
Yeah. More easy.
I mean, at least just having links to the FTP master website or something from release.debian.org would be good.
Well,
no, it's
the
about
concern is that having it on the same machine makes it easier to do commit pushes.
Yes, commit pushes, extract data from the database and everything else.
Yeah.
And at the moment you have a very good overview of what is still to be processed.
Yes.
But everything that happens after that is completely invisible.
Yeah.
You have no idea what's happening on the build these. You have no idea what's why things are stuck there.
Yeah.
I thought Jeroen had added some functionality to his build the overview pages that you could see other suites as well, but I cannot find it anywhere.
Actually, the other suites is not the list exported for some reason. Therefore, the security suites are standard. But perhaps we need to export all the lists for the other suites. Basically, I think stable release management and viewability of information has been a large step forward in the last whatever 1 to 2 years, but there's also still large way to go. So,
yeah. But for people who have to coordinate or check things like I do, it's extremely frustrating if you cannot get the information and have to ping people over and over again.
Yeah,
so
you're right. Your Runes page does have now. Basically just append dist equals testing or dist equals stable.
It's not documented anywhere, I think.
So I thought I saw it as a form option on the page.
Huh.
I thought.
France,
I'm not sure.
I think we should just link such things to the release DO page.
Yeah.
Perhaps, do you write down? I will just write down.
Of course, these are all, you realize these are pages that run on buildd.debian.org that are written in PHP, so Ryan's not really pleased about that in general.
okay, so perhaps I should speak with Ryan how we could add that information to the release DO web page.
Zobel points out on IRC that you could just use stack.ls on Merkle.
That doesn't tell you you want to build status, though. That will tell you the...
Yeah, the main thing that will tell you now is approvals after things have made it through the...
You cannot get any wannable information from the project gateway.
Yeah.
That's something totally different. So
you can't get wannable information from the build D webpage?
Well, you can, but not from the project B database.
Yeah, build the web.
No.
The build the web pages you can get. I don't think there's any links. Does he have any?
No, standard's not published.
Unstable is the only stuff that's published. That's the only place
you
can find. You can even find links to build logs. I think is. Can you?
Yeah.
Can you guess the build log? No.
If you know the package, you can find them because they are just listed in the full list for the package.
Are they even stable?
Yeah.
And,
yeah,
but not the security ones. Only the stable ones.
Right. But wanna build. As far as overall database status or anything,
no.
You can't get.
No.
About it wouldn't be too hard to get an export from one build whatever every 2 hours and add it to the release DO page or so. It's not so many packages.
I mean, all the rest of it is on buildy.do, and that's a separate host than FTP master anyway. So
yeah, whatever.
So just put
but
it on
the
DO.
Since when is it?
Has been for ages.
It's a separate house since Bilti moved from away from ULEF.
Okay. Yeah, you're right.
Because Bilti stayed on ULEF, and FTP master moved to Spore.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't really know. I thought it was still the same thing. Okay.
No, that's separated. But I just said I will speak with Muro about it anyways, because I'm not going to link a PHP page he's not happy about.
I still don't still have some PHP pages of my own that I use on there. But,
but as long as he doesn't know, he's not unhappy about them.
I need to work with him about, because he was working on replacing them all with CGI scripts, and I need to work with him on exactly what the issues are that leave me going back to my PHP pages instead.
We will see. Okay, I just noted down as an issue we should do.
Yes, please.
Okay. And who next wants to say something? It's not necessary to be a release manager to speak here, so please feel free to say anything, what you would, or ask anything, or...
So what are the plans for DI and kernel updates for the stable or not stable releases?
For the current one?
Are we going to have new hardware support, or are we just going to have security updates?
For R1, we don't have anything planned. The new hardware support will happen eventually. So, like you were saying earlier, stuff like adding PCI IDs and things like that will do an edge. And then we're talking about in January or so, almost a year after Edge is released, we're looking at adding a new kernel in as a secondary option for Edge.
So that you can still run the...
The default kernels will still be
right. The main question is, which hasn't been resolved yet, how are you going to deal with that in the installer? Are you going to support new kernel? Are you going to support both of them? Or are you basically going to say we only support for the installed system, which is rather useless?
Or you can say you can install on G6.18 and then upgrade easily.
Yeah, but that doesn't help you. If you need SATA access, you don't have it.
Yeah.
We don't just do new kernels for the...
What you could do is take the unstable installer using running the unstable kernel and install testing using a business card image or a network image. Mm-hmm. That would work, probably.
Yeah, but actually I would really like to see a stable DI installer which has a new kernel UDEPs included,
yeah,
so that you can just go to a new machine,
yeah,
install it.
But the big question then is that kernel is going to have very little testing, probably.
Probably.
So what are you going to do with regressions? Because you don't want to have two simultaneous stable versions of the installer. For one thing, CD image could never handle that.
Yeah. No, we just need one. I'm not too sure if we say we don't do. We only add something like netinst equivalent to it, so that we have only one CD more. Or only the multi-arch CD or whatever.
It also isn't that easy to install it, because you would have basically two current first, so all your web pages would have to have dual links as well.
Yes.
It's going to be a mess.
I agree that there's still a lot of unresolved issues in that.
Yeah.
What's the problem with CD images?
The server is full.
Space.
It takes a huge amount of disk space to host such images.
Especially now that we're increasingly clever about combining them onto.
Yeah. Build yards and such. Yeah.
Is it neuroned anyway, or?
It's mirrored. Yeah. It's
the archive itself, or
no? It's a separate mirror.
But a lot of mirrors opt in on mirroring the CD images as well.
Okay,
you basically have three types of mirrors. You have the archive mirrors, the website mirrors, and the CD image mirrors.
Do you have rough figures of the disk space it takes?
No idea.
No,
sledge.
Terabyte could be.
I don't know.
But it's really huge. We needed to ask it to
DVDs for binary PR.
It's 20
two
plus CDs.
Three DVD images.
Well,
plus the multi
RC stuff. It's actually just two DVD images plus an extra CD at all.
Just
slightly over three.
Multiple architectures. We needed last time to async all the stuff over the world. We need about one day to async the stuff between servers, which is really a huge number. Yes?
Okay.
So.
On a gigabit line.
Yes. It's really much stuff.
Yeah, not a terabyte, but probably a tenth of a terabyte at least. So
yeah.
100 some gig.
There might be a way to only have to change the first CD.
Yeah, is that awesome?
Not really. That's not possible because
yeah,
CDs are filled to the max. And so as soon as CD1 grows a little bit, then stuff would have to be pushed to CD2.
Unless
they are built as sets at the moment, and you have to change the CD, Debian CD setup to be able to support that.
Fine, but okay, let's now perhaps come back to another point what you said about that you expect there will be some regressions. What I would like to do, if we say we go with set kernel, that we publish the kernel in time and say, well, please test set kernel. A lot of users even running stable who might be interested in running a newer kernel so that we have a serious amount of testing on that kernel before we publish it.
Can't you go through backports or something to work on
this? Well, we have an auto-built system. It doesn't do all architectures, but Waldi has buildserver.net.
Yeah.
There's auto-built kernels there. And it auto-builds, the kernel we're planning on would be auto-built for SID, but we need to, we'll have to make some changes and set up the site.
What I meant is, can you go upload this kernel to backports and have tested there or something?
You can push it in proposed updates early.
Yes,
sure.
Proposed updates is public, and these days you can really, if you're an experienced Debian user, you can really run proposed updates in your sources list.
Okay. Yeah.
Even if you're not that experienced, really.
You should at least know what bug the system is before you do it.
Yeah.
Right.
Good opportunity.
Yeah.
I learned if you don't know.
True.
Yeah, but it's now more or less moderated, so only stuff goes in that's really accepted.
Yeah.
That's a great improvement in my opinion. And so I would push the kernel there and perhaps make an announcement on DDA that the kernel is there, please test it and blog about it and whatever, and then it will happen.
Okay. Sounds reasonable.
So I think we could make sure that we get proper testing. Of course, the other points are still to be resolved.
And as long as the installer doesn't support multiple sources for UDEPs, it's a real pain to test installations with a new kernel before everything is integrated and stable. We cannot say, okay, take from stable and from proposed updates when loading UDEPs.
Do
we need to make the proposed updates include all of stable UDEPs?
Then we would still need to modify the installer to actually look at the proposed update, but that would help, I guess. Yes, that would make testing a lot easier.
That shouldn't be so hard, though.
Not really.
And we can set the suite where we take UDEPs from easily. So if that's an option, that would work definitely.
Okay. Well, we can put that in the next box.
No, that's not so hard because it's just a dark control suite, anyways.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's basically it. For stable and old stable, I would have liked to have the stable and old stable updates out much sooner.
Yes. I too. I don't think anybody is especially browsed and is so late.
Yes, that's the least. Basically, Zobel and I started talking about doing stable updates and old stable updates really soon after release of Edge, because old stable installations are completely broken at the moment. You cannot properly install old stable using the Sarge installer.
Is that a problem?
Yes. Especially since it's not that hard to fix.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So the change then needs a DI update?
Yeah. But we also want to get the kernel updates in for that. Because you don't want to do an R1 release and then an R2 release because the API changes again.
Why didn't we get the DI update before it was released?
Because we didn't know the problem existed, to be honest. We suspected it would probably exist, but it's hard to test and so on when you're not in the situation.
Yeah. So what time frame is the stable release team looking at for between point updates?
Actually, with the first point update, I think it would have been good to make the first point update something like 6 to 8 weeks after the stable release, because then we have seen also rough spots that needed an update soon. And after that, my personal opinion, without discussing this further, would be something like 2 to 3 months. But that relies on the fact that most point updates...
But for the first point update, you'd say sooner than 2 or 3 months.
Yes, because
it's been 2 months now.
Actually, I would say the first should be sooner, because on the release itself, we noticed a few rough spots shortly after the release, which requires fixing. It also depends on how important is the point update. So if you say, well, basically this time the point update just consists of this spinning all security updates on the disk, mm-hmm. I would say, well, we do it whenever we have time. If we say we have important changes in DI to make, it should perhaps happen a bit earlier.
Zobel on IRC says 2 months, and that testing DI before a point release would help, dot dot dot. The IRC channel is #DebConf upper box.
What?
#DebConf-upper
okay.
BOFS.
Right.
On BOFH.
So you're basically our IRC moderator.
I was thinking more relay, but whatever.
I heard DebConf-Hufflepuff for what it's
worth. What?
I still haven't, not, I have no clue what you actually said still. That was my first time around, so I just...
That's something like what I understood as well. Hufflepuff the house in Harry Potter.
Yes. Gotcha, right.
Yes, moving to #DebConf.
That would be a good idea for next year, just name your rooms after...
Use 2.6 update in testing or post updates is okay, in your opinion?
Yeah, there's only... and I'm building it right now and to get FAI kernels rebuilt against the latest source, but everything else I think is ready to go.
So we can... I speak about the TPU update. So we can just approve the TPU update, so we could...
Oh, yes, the TPU update, yes.
So, okay, I just approved it.
What do you have in TPU? That's kernel.
We need a new kernel in testing before we can let the Edge kernel in.
Yeah, it turns out...
What happened with that? Was that when you deployed the PU new? Are you aware of that, bro?
Well, it turns out that Neuro said you can do this all manually, uh-huh. but I already uploaded the Lini 1 version 4 Lini, and that broke him being able to do it manually. Still have to go ahead and release
that. Well, my question was, DAC used to have a check in place that would prevent uploads of versions.
Not sure it ever actually worked.
It did work
in the time frame prior to PU news creation.
I tested that when I created the patches for the coping stuff to unstable as well and so.
Yeah, so
I guess in theory that also goes for the installer, which does not have a newer version in testing at the moment, and is extremely unlikely to get one.
You can change that.
Especially as Bastian has now decided that he's not going to bother about migrating kernel before uploading the new one.
Yes, that's why I'm buying my dad's kernel from TPU now.
Yeah, well.
But we all know who we can look at for kernel migration.
That's right, if he breaks it in unstable, I'll just re upload the old one to TPU and hit it myself. Huh?
It's probably the best option.
I haven't even looked at the modules, so I need to do that and figure out where all the module packages are before we can really look at 2.6.21 and test it. Uh-huh. Seriously.
2.6.21 is still broken for quite a few arches.
Is it?
APPA mainly.
I'm not sure what it works on GTK.
And there are also some build failures still for loop AES. For example, which would have to go as well.
Yes, but I think those build failures were related to the kernel itself, were they?
I'm not sure. It could be bin used as well, but there's a lot of stuff that's broken that's related to new kernels, new GCC and whatever.
Yeah.
I
thought we had the kernel building on all ours, though, including HPPA.
Yeah, it builds, but it doesn't run.
Hmm.
What if the RC bugged to tell me that? Like,
I filed a few bugs. I think they were in RC.
No, I didn't see them.
I don't know.
I think Steve, we need to talk off about filling bugs with a light severity.
Yeah.
There's an enemy behind you.
But anyway, that's why we haven't got all the installer architectures on 21 at the moment. Still a few on 18.
Okay. Yes, that's a little bad thing. That the kernel in unstable isn't in the shape I would like to be.
Mm-hmm.
To say it in a nice way.
But as I said, a lot is due to toolchain changes.
Yeah, toolchain is an important part of it.
Yeah.
Okay. Any further things? Did we cover the kernel now?
Oh, I can repeat some more stuff from Zobel on IRC. His idea is to do a point release every month, so old stable point release 1 month and then stable point release the next and alternate that way.
Mm-hmm.
But currently there's too much waiting for build Ds and security packages not built on all architectures.
Which channel are you, by the way? How's it?
DebConf dash upper UPPER box BOFS.
So
the room
where you upper box.
And that has just joined. And I suspect it's not a secret channel, so you can just go.
I know HSS, you know channel is secret. I can remember very well what you posted in Vancouver. It wasn't me who published Elmo's ad mails.
Huh?
It wasn't me who published his mails.
Okay, whatever.
Okay. Yeah, I think that would be really the same thing to both alternating, and then we would have the good situation that not all R updates are so hard to do, but that we have some easier ones as well.
Yeah.
I wonder if it's worth doing a full CD rebuild every 2 months for old stable.
I think an update CD would be enough.
It also takes this space.
So basically we need Steve here.
There is a good reason for making upgrade disks. I know one company who runs Debian, which have a very wired policy, because they are only allowed, or the subcontractor who is operating the servers is only allowed to bring stuff in, which is an official media from the developer, from the persons who are from publishers, or where the subcontractor takes the full.
That's not
validity.
A concern for the projects, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm not so sure. And so that's a reason why we should have at least update CDs. With update CDs, you have a media you can bring in. It's a media.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
and I think creating update CDs is enough for all stables.
Yeah, as far as CDs, didn't Debian CD already drop the full mirror of old stable when Etch was released on grounds of lack of space on the mirror network?
I think it's still on there.
On CD,
what?
It's still on CD image, but not on the build part, as far as I remember.
Right, so we no longer have mirroring of old stable CDs.
Okay. Well, we only have very few places, also,
yeah,
which is fair.
Oh yes, that's yeah.
Because they said there's no
yeah.
way they could carry both
yeah.
sets all.
It's mirrors. It's in CD archive now.
Okay.
But that's normal. One thing I would like to bring up related to release management in general is that I think it's too focused on getting the archive right, and that some other things that need to be done for release are left too much to chance. And if you're a release manager, you should manage the whole and not
so
part. Such as
somehow
release notes.
Yeah,
maybe.
Release notes echoing in my ears.
Actually, what I wrote in the mail was that release notes, we as the release team definitely started way too late with release notes. And I'm really impressed again how good the release notes
And it is this later. But we will need to make it better next time.
The thing is that we have promised translators that for R1, newly available translations will be included. And there are a number of bug reports about changes that should be made in the release notes.
Okay.
Which means that translators will need to update their translations.
Right, so
and you can only build release notes if translators are reasonably up to date.
Yeah. Okay.
And that process is not being managed.
Okay, I will put that on my to-do list very high.
Okay.
Because I have seen how the release notes work, and I think I'm still one of the editors even.
And the tarball creation has to be enabled again when translations are up to date, and so on, and so on, and so on.
Mm-hmm. I know there's a lot of stuff included. I will follow it as one of my top items. Okay.
If you have questions about it, please feel free to ask me, but I'm not going to get involved.
Yes, I can understand you.
Okay.
Yes, I would ask you, if Frank Lichtenheld is also one of the persons who knows something about it.
Yeah.
I put it in my priority list now.
But keep it as a fixed item for future releases,
yes,
as well.
But for this one,
it's more important.
It's more important. What I would like to do is just write down what needs to be done in which order, and then just put it somewhere so that other people could do the same.
What was I thinking just now? Just continue on. Catch up.
So how's the security propagation for stable working?
Bad.
The propagation back up into testing?
No, the propagation from the security update getting into proposed updates for R1 or whatever.
My best, you just ask Zobel about that because he always complains.
Missing builds on architectures like ARM and Spark.
Yeah, I prefer Zobel's answer. He says that's working fine. I'll just be selective about who I listen to. No, he can stop talking now.
Because the edits of you're often missing, waiting for missing architectures. The bad thing, by the way, with the missing architectures, they will really have an issue.
So, are they missing from security.debian.org?
Sometimes.
Just from the first updates?
From security. For example, what happens if there's a security update that doesn't contain all architectures? If we accept it then in PU, new, then it will be auto-built both in security and on proposed updates, and we end up with different depths in both sides,
yeah,
which is really a no option, I think. That is something we have to do about it. I'm not sure what the right approach to it is.
Well, the right approach.
Don't accept that the build is complete.
Well, to have it complete quickly in security.
Yeah, so complete. It's a great option.
So why do you have any idea why that's not happening?
I don't know. In every case, in a few cases, it's people just trying to track down the builds more. It would be a better person to ask, but builds just don't seem to appear sometimes, or
well,
it's machine down.
It's also true that mostly security builds are done on machines that also do unstable, and while they are prioritized, sometimes if there's already a build running or if unstable is backlogged, then you can have issues with the security build being late for some reason on that architecture.
Well, maybe by one day, but not one week.
No, that's true.
Building open office, it can't be a week.
I also have sometimes the impression, I couldn't prove it, but I have sometimes the impression that between some members of the security team and some build team and administrators, the communications are not working so well.
Well, I'm not maintaining any build team that actually also does security, so I'm not really speaking first on experience there. But usually, when a security build is done, the security people actually get the build log as well.
Yeah.
So, and they, I believe it's even them.
I ask the communication in the case like, oh, why didn't the build appear? So what you should do, or what I think would listen to this thing to do is to write a mail to build the app in it, or
they
whoever
usually
said.
They usually do
yeah.
that. I see them sometimes on our mail list. They
oh,
do
okay.
that. That's not the issue. But yeah, sometimes, obviously, if you got a build running on stable, sometimes that breaks, or well, that shouldn't break the stable builds, but if you disable your build even to fix your unstable, then that can also
they also fix to anything. Yes, that's correct.
Right. So there's it can interfere because they're on the same host. It shouldn't happen, but yeah, sometimes.
Yes, I can even remember, I think, some such cases like build demons were totally disabled because something was totally broken, unstable, and then after asking the admins again about it, they were re-enabled only for security.
Yeah.
Yes, but such things are really painful and
sure.
painful.
Yeah, sure. But it's also usually an exception, I think. Yes. I don't know how often it happens that a build doesn't agree for security.
Almost always.
Almost always. Okay, so then this should not be the reason. Then something else going on. I don't know about. Sorry.
Well, Martin just said that the current architecture I have lots of issues are with ARM and Spark,
mm-hmm.
and sometimes with M68K.
Yeah, that I know. That's like that's because that's usually because M68K is built on unstable
mm-hmm.
and that takes a while.
But basically, we have at least three fast ARM build demons, so we shouldn't have issues there.
Well, there are issues with ARM currently. I've been lurking on the ARM mailing list, and they have, I think, four machines doing building stuff, with two being offered to run as build demon for months and nothing happening to them.
You mean 3 months?
Well, months.
Yeah, months, 3 months, 6 months.
Okay.
Bill Gaiman's machine has been an offer that's been outstanding for over a year, actually.
That's what
I don't know any
that's
details
what I thought
about.
Yeah,
about
that's actually, it's a machine which is...
Bill Gaitliff, he's the
right.
guy in
yeah.
Illinois. Yeah, I know his
and that's a 600 megahertz machine, whereas the other ones are 200 or 300 megahertz.
Machine. Yeah, we literally
so
accept that machine.
Sorry?
I really think we should accept that machine.
Yeah, I think so too, but I mean...
I don't know if
it's
anyway.
The thing is, on the ARM mail list, and I think that's a really problematic situation there, people don't even know why it's not being accepted, whereas that's the Portis mail list, and I don't think that's a great healthy situation there.
Wasn't hosting the issue with that specific machine?
I don't know.
No, the machines are hosted somewhere.
The owner
is a Debian log machine.
The owner is offering hosting. The owner is actually not a DD. I don't know if that's a factor.
No.
There are. Well, I mean, there are.
There are other machines. I think most building machines are hosted by people who are not DD.
And if it would be an issue, because there's certainly enough hosting offers by the DDs
right.
or by the departments on the DDs.
Most build DDs actually do have a local admin who is a DD. They may be hosted.
Yes, but
there's
usually also a local admin who's not a DD. So
true. Yeah. But I don't actually know what for sure
what I'm saying is just I don't think that's the reason.
The main problem is that you don't get the information about
right.
the bar
exactly.
Yet.
Otherwise, you wouldn't speculate now, but say the reason is that.
Right, so that's a main problem.
I know there's also a bug tracking request open for a very nice offer of a Spark machine.
Joyce?
Yes,
you're
separated.
Yeah.
We have enough Sparks, basically. And we have.
We do?
We do.
Where?
You mean
active or you mean offer?
We could just set up two more in Darmstadt if you want.
There's only one active, basically.
The only live Spark right now is Spunky.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened. The Porter system for Spark has been down forever now.
Yeah.
And the Oric has been down as a build D for 2 months now. I don't know where it went.
Steve, we have enough machines.
Yeah.
We have hosting offers. We have IP addresses. We are now setting up next. We are just about setting up.
There's
a machine there.
You are talking about available hardware. You're not talking about
configurabilities
or machines that are actually being considered by DSA to be added.
So
as
I'm not speaking about the last slide. I've offered machines there more than once to DSA.
And we were talking about machines actually running and available for work. So if you then say we have enough Spark,
no. we have enough good offers for Spark. That's what I meant. Good means hosting included, reliable.
Please file the request tracker bugs.
I can do again.
Make it visible that there are offers.
Yeah, because the only offer I know of that's
is Joyce. Yeah.
Now, as far as ARM, today I believe all of the build deeds are back up and running. All six of the build deeds.
Six could be.
That's Grieg, Toffee. What's the other one in that class?
So we have three fast. I thought we have three fast ones and two slow ones.
We have three slow ones.
Okay.
Ilara, Europa, and Netwinder are the three slow ones. So there's six of them.
Where's Netwinder located?
Beedale's basement.
Okay. I missed that one.
Netwinder is netwinder.gag.com.
Yeah, I have two measures of the basement as well.
But they were disabled for.
They were disabled. They have been disabled because of the issue where they were running a kernel that was too old to be compatible with glibc.
Yeah.
That's been resolved, and as far as I'm aware, all three of those have been reactivated now. So.
And that was basically a tool chain issue again.
Yeah, I mean, it took a while to get it going
again,
but as far as I know, they are up and running now. So, in terms of where ARM is, in terms of power, it has been catching up with the backlog.
Is that PowerPC machine that was
Voltaire?
Moved, yeah, is that back up?
I don't know.
I suspect not.
There were, Snowman has been online and talking about it, and it's not. There are some specific issues with the hardware and with his local hosting that
that was something problem with the mail.
Yeah, there was a firewall issue, and the second problem was when Ryan was looking at it one night, he was just poking around in the system because he was trying to figure out if he could take Voltaire's kernel and put it on Mailo so that Mailo could build on stable again. He looked at proc CPU info, and proc CPU info was reporting temperatures on the processors, and one of them was like three times the temperature of the other three processors.
Oh,
and
gosh.
So it's like, is that a hardware failure? So I think actually Voltaire was, last I knew, was it was being taken offline so that Snowman could look at that, but I don't know.
Just
I don't know if it's back up or not. What's that?
It's responding to pings, if that means anything. It's responding to pings.
So
the machines
currently the boxes?
In OK.
Voltaire,
I don't know if it's been. Doesn't seem to be accepting SSH connections, though.
So that could be his firewall talking for everyone who knows.
That's true.
The CPU burning.
So, but yeah, Mailo is up, and Mailo wasn't building on stable for the longest time because of another kernel issue, which I didn't realize that had been the case, but yeah. After managing to walk himself out of it once, he got the local admins to agree with that, and so Mailo's been building now, and so RPC is keeping up with just the one, and Voltaire is somewhere on the edge.
Okay.
How did we get into this whole discussion about buildies anyway? That's what we're supposed to be talking about.
Because we always end up as buildies.
But I don't think we're going to solve anything about buildies right here, are we?
Okay.
Unlikely.
Well, we've got lots of laptops.
Everybody got QE related up.
How about talk to Sledge about CD releases for stable and old stable?
Yeah.
What to do with them? Whether to just do incremental update CDs or and when to rebuild. We should have a policy for that.
Yes. I had just my list of
issues. Sorry, technically this pop session is meant to be over now, sorry.
now we can switch the camera off and continue talking about
it. It's 12 minutes of tape.
Is the bar open yet?
Do we have another topic for the stable release?
Well, I've got a schedule, but can we do a 3107 this week while we're on here?
What?
Is that possible? Can we do the next Sarge update this week? Is there anything holding that up?
Edge update?
Sarge, not Edge.
Oh, Sarge.
Yeah.
Sarge is
Sarge
the health of,
the
I cannot upload the I yet for Sarge.
Sarge is
why
the
not?
Okay. Because I have about four or five architects missing for the UDAPs I've uploaded.
Which one?
I don't know.
Okay.
I've told Sobel to look into it.
Sorry.
Please.
You can look at the page.
Yeah, well, not the UDAPs.
I cannot see anything on the page.
Why not?
Because it doesn't link stuff that's already been accepted. Or are we talking about a completely different page that's possible?
Are we talking again about not being able to see one of those status for tape for things that aren't unstable?
Yeah. Yeah. The only thing I can do at this moment is to do R medicine basically and check what's available, but I cannot see anything beyond that.
Yeah.
And it's been unchanged for at least a week and a half. The same architecture missing, so it looks like nobody's paying any attention.
So do you know one of the packages you uploaded?
Choose mirror.
It's hyphenated?
Yes. Root scale is another. Zobel pinged Elmo about it yesterday, so something may have happened.
Choose mirrors and needs build on R.
And page and store is the third.
Choose mirror, want to build status, I see uploaded or needs build for all arcs.
Okay.
In old stable. So that means if it's been accepted, it's not clear. Yeah. Back to want to build.
So arms need builds, M68Ks needs build.
Four.
Choose mirror. HPBA needs build. I386 is needs build.
Which that actually appears to be a bug in this balance upload.
The question is why it's staying slow, because they have been there for the past 2 weeks or something like that.
Yeah.
Well, they're all sitting in needs build, so it's not they're not building, so they haven't been picked up at all by a build D.
Zobel says it seems that there are a few build Ds not configured for old stable
that's
first updates.
That's what I was just going to say.
Regular packages are being built, aren't they? Or that's
no,
not via security.
I guess the security one is old
data
is different than this.
Yeah.
Than
this.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
not
a
different speed.
What is old data security?
We haven't had old stable for first updates until now.
So I think that's the main issue. I think the old stable
want
to build it, but it just isn't being used.
Okay, so this needs to be fixed, of course.
Yeah, and that's also why I've been trying to push it to Zobel instead of trying to go after it myself, because I suspected it was something structural.
Yeah,
yes.
I don't see why I should have to run after that. But it's,
see for the M6 again.
Choose mirror package, yes?
Choose mirror, base installer, and root scale. And I think those are the arc-any packages, the only arc-any packages I uploaded.
That's missing on M68K, on ES64, on SC90 and on Spark.
The list of architects where they were missing were the same for all three.
Yeah. Just put it.
It makes sense. Are we going to be kicked out by the next buff?
Yeah, he's going to the next buff.